Toxic relationship, love addiction, unhealthy relationship, when is enough enough? Hi guys, my name is Lena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. Let's talk about unhealthy relationship. What to do when you love someone and he treats you badly? What to do when the person that you love is keeping hurting you emotionally? When is enough enough? When we love somebody, we try to find reasons to explain his bad behavior. And it can sound like this. He had a hard day at work. He had a bad conversation with his parents. He had an argument with his friends. He's going through difficult times in his life. He does not feel good. He's in a bad mood. And in reality, we are looking for excuses. We're looking for excuses so we can feel still good about that person that we love. Another common reaction is when we start blaming ourselves. When we say, he is behaving like this because of me. This is my fault. I was not supposed to ask that. I was supposed to find the better words. I was not kind enough. I did not ask him how was his day. I start talking about my problems. So this is my fault. He is a good person and I'm always doing something wrong and I'm always making him feel bad and feel angry. So his reaction is not bad. I was the trigger for that reaction. So we're blaming ourselves when in reality the other person is treating us badly. A lot of people who are in such relationship will say, but how can I know if it's not my fault? Maybe it is my fault. Maybe I did something wrong. So my answer is, if you feel bad, terrible, miserable, ashamed, and guilty most of the time when you were with that person, then it's not your fault. Because there are other people in your life and you probably don't feel those feelings every time. And even if you did something wrong, even if you said something bad, even if you were not kind enough, it can happen. We all human and there are no perfect people, there are no perfect relationships. So if you did something bad in the relationship, and I'm not saying you cheated on the person, but maybe you were rude or maybe you used not the proper word to tell him about your feelings. But do you feel miserable, ashamed, bad, neglected all the time or most of the time with that person? If yes, then this is not your fault. In my video, if you remember, about unrequited love, the links will be below, I was saying what's the reason why we attracted to such people in our life, why we feel love towards those people. And I'm saying that it's not about love, it's about trauma. So if you want to know the reasons why we're doing this, the links will be below. Today, I would like to tell you what to do if you are in those relationships. And the answer is leave. You have to leave those relationships. No matter how much you love the person, no matter how much you feel connected to that person, you have to leave. Why is it so hard to leave? Because we feel scared, because we don't want to be alone, because we're afraid to go and look for someone else. Because we believe that one day that person will see me for who I am, will see through me, and will change and realize and fall in love with me. Sometimes people can be in those relationships for 5, 7, 10, and even more years. So if the person does not respect you right now, if the person does not value you, he's not gonna do it in the future. He's not. This is the person that's not about you, that's about him or about her. And the question is, do you love yourself enough? Do you respect yourself? Do you value yourself? Because if you don't value yourself, if you don't respect yourself, you cannot expect it from other person. And you can say, yes, I love myself. If you love yourself, why you're in those relationships? How long are you willing to stay in those relationships? How much disrespect, neglect, shame, all those bad, terrible feelings do you need to feel in order to say enough? We are extremely creative. We can find reasons and we can find unique circumstances in order to stay in the relationship. And we can even say that he is not angry with me. I understand that he is a bad person, but I'm a kind person. I'm loving, I'm caring. I will send my love to him and one day it will change little by little. Probably not. Probably in 99.9% he's not gonna change. And you're gonna keep pretending to be kind, keep pretending to be understanding. But in reality, deep inside yourself, you know that it's painful. You know that you feel bad every time. You feel neglected, you feel ashamed, you feel disrespectful. Again, again, and again. It's very hard, extremely difficult to leave such relationship. But the longer you stay, the harder it's gonna be. So it's okay, ask your friends to help you in this situation. It's okay to ask your relatives to give you support in this situation. And it's even better if you're gonna go and find the professional help. You need to figure out why are you in those relationships? Why it's so hard for you to leave? Because if you don't figure out it for yourself, the next relationship will be similar, or probably it's gonna be even worse. So if you are in an abusive, emotionally abusive relationship and you feel neglected, terrible, you feel pain all the time, you feel that the person does not value you, so my advice is go to a therapy and find the professional person who is gonna help you to overcome this situation. Because there is always other option for you. Because there is always loving, caring, supportive, and fulfilling, passionate relationship. And you can feel mutual love, and you can feel mutual respect and mutual support. Don't afraid to ask your questions. Share your thoughts below in the comments box in this video. If you have a private question, contact me. I will be happy to hear your questions. And remember that your question might be the topic of the next video. And you can receive a free, absolutely free consultation as a video answer here on YouTube. Share this video with your friends, post it on your Facebook, spread out the word about my channel, subscribe because I release new videos every week. Check out my playlist for different topics, love, sex, money, success, relationship. And thank you for watching Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life.